Hello and welcome, fellow gamers. My name is Borek and this is another episode of 7 Days to Die in Starvation Mode. Looking at my view page, well, you guys seem to be really interested in this mode, which really makes me happy. So, in a couple of days, I've been extremely busy and I will be extremely busy during next week or two since I am moving next week. So there might be a lack of videos going on my channel, and I do apologize for that right from the start. I am really appreciated that you guys are so active. So after looking for gauges, you guys told me that I can find gauges in cars. So I've been going since the morning today, and I have already found one gauge just by decomposing cars. So that is quite true, and I would really like to find out at which stage you can find gauges. So now we have the stage 2. We didn't got any gauge, but we got battery, which is cool. And I think gauges might be in the same loot table as small engines and batteries. But I want to find out and test my theory on that. We actually only need to check after every single stage. No new gauge. So yeah, that is part of the plan. Though I think that gauges might be a bit lower. The probability of finding gauge might be a bit lower than finding engine or battery. But hopefully I will find out at which stage we can get those. Alright, so during the night time I did some digging. I have found really nice and pleasant copper vein that is not quite so far from here. Actually, that is in the pine forest. The first time where I found copper, which was somewhere over here, during two nights I went there, secured the place, and found like 200 or something like that, which was really extremely fun thing to do. Right, so I'm gonna continue going through the cars over here, killing zombies and whatnot, and hopefully I will find another gauge so that we can build the biggest diesel generator. No new gauge. Right, so as soon as I finish doing that, I will let you know, guys. And look what I have found. A sheep. This is so cool. I haven't found a sheep until today, which is really cool. Although I don't have... Oh, thank you for the bullets. Oh, yes, I do. I actually do have the ladder on me, so we can make a whip on a go, and maybe we would be able to catch the first sheep of the series. That would be really awesome. Though, first of all, let's take care of that lady. Oh, thank you for the food. Unfortunately, I can hear spider somewhere nearby, but that is not gonna be the problem. Right, so let's get that sheep. Oh, shit. Oh. It survived. How awesome. Though, not so awesome. Oh, shit. Ooh, there is a snake. Let's watch out for the snake. And the ship seems to be having a weird-ass animation. Yeah, that didn't work. That didn't work as I planned. But we can check if we can get No, we can't. Ah, that sucked. Well, I was hoping to get wool or something, but I think we need scissors for that. Scissors? Not medical scissors. Scissors, those scissors. Warning, excessive harvesting can kill your livestock. Okay, cool, fair enough. No, I do have my inventory full, so that's why I shall return back home, leave some stuff back home, and then return to trying to find cages. If only I have just a few seconds of free time. Yeah. Okay, be right back. Alrighty, guys, so I've been taking apart like cars like crazy. I haven't found a gauge just yet, but as you can see, amount of lead batteries, small engines, and over here my mini bike is full with gas cans and batteries and engines and stuff like that. So I was taking apart cars right over there, and oh, hello. Let's take care of you first. This is so bad. This is so bad because I cannot do anything about it. Okay, I can scrap that. I can scrap it. I can scrap that as well. Right. So, I found this tank right over here. And I was wondering if we can take apart cars. Can we take apart those? And apparently you can, and you can get springs and mechanical parts and other stuff such as gunpowder, which is really super duper cool and awesome. And I did not knew that you can take apart those. I hope that it's not gonna blow up on me, because that would suck like donkey balls. But we'll take it apart together, all 5,000 durability, and we shall see how much gunpowder we can take, especially gunpowder, because it seems to be very specific for this type of vehicle, which of course is really awesome. I've been gathering those electrical and electronics for the last, I don't know, 20 minutes. It's been like 6 in-game hours, almost something like that, and I haven't found a single gauge. Oh, we got another engine, so probably another thing that we will gather, we can get out of it. It's gonna be dropped on the floor. Unfortunately, I don't have means to take it with me. I can throw away some frames if we do find this mystical gauge, but it seems that I have a really hard time getting that. Right, did we got anything? No. I'm still expecting the battery, and I don't know if there's gonna be any second layer of this vehicle. If so, then probably I will have to return here and take it apart without you guys, because it takes so long to do so. We haven't dropped anything, so that is quite awesome. But the amount of engines, batteries and stuff like that, I can make like 15 mini bikes at this point. Right, so that is gone, nothing dropped. Unfortunately, I did not get that gauge, so right now having all those batteries and copper back home, I shall return home and make that electric butt, electric spear, and then we will go and test it out. Alrighty then, so I have returned back home, and this is the total amount of engines, batteries and gas that I do have, because all that batteries and engines did not fit over here, so I moved them. Actually, we do have one more battery over here, which is awesome, which is of course awesome. And now I'm gonna put those in here, and in total we got 143 gunpowder from that tank. Well, actually that is not the tank, but you know what I mean. And the pistol I'm gonna keep, because we will set another guard on the other side of the base, right over there. So also I have queued up some stuff being to be made by Smith, and Smith was making those shotgun stocks, and now he's at level zero. Yeah, that sucks. Okay, that was stupid.
I don't know why I have done this. Misclicked, I guess. What the fuck have I done? And why the hell does he have so much stuff? Assault rifle barrel. Where did he got that? Armor plate. Maybe I should switch to some other thing, but okay, fair enough. Fuel deposit. Well, yeah, that sucked. That sucked quite badly. But still, no biggie. You're really not that big of a deal. Sorry about that, Mr. Smith. I have started the generator down there to summon another male survival. Hopefully, they will be somewhere around here. But we shall see. Right, first of all, before we do anything else, you guys told me that I can destroy those to get fruit chips. Oh, fantastic. Fullness 2 and wellness. Ah, that sucked. And that's meat drying rack. But this is awesome. Nevertheless, this is awesome, I think. So we got 2 and we can increase our fullness. That is fantastic. And what did we get? 5. 5 beef jerkies. Look at that. They have fullness of 4 and wellness plus 1. So now we have 2 additional drying racks. And I was wondering if we can, for example, take some more and make more of those drying racks with meat, because meat seems to be much better than fruits, and probably they will last longer than normal food. I mean, won't spoil so quickly, but we're not going to be testing it out in today's episode, right? But we still can increase our wellness by doing so. As I said earlier, I got some copper from the mine, and look at that, 215. That's what I got during the night, which is really awesome. And we'll need some batteries because we are gonna be making electric bat. We will need baseball bat for that, barbed wire, copper and lead battery, and we'll need forged iron, short iron pipes, copper, lead battery and some springs. Probably I won't remember all of that, but at least I can try. And short iron pipes, we have plenty. Right, we need a workbench. Maybe that's gonna be the workbench that we do require for that. Electric spear. No. Maybe over here? No, that's not the place where I can make it. Maybe over here? Nope. So, on that note, I think we have one last workbench, but I don't think we can make any weapons. Oh, hello. Shit, you gave me such a fright. Lady, actually, I don't need you, so you can piss off, honestly. I need 2 males. 2 males. What sucks is that you cannot use woman as a guard, so that really, honestly, sucks. We have a screamer outside, and I have absolutely no idea where can I make that electric bat. Powered by an all-cut battery, stuns the target using electric power. Well, that's grand, but where can I make it? Is there, like, weapon spawn bench? We have this weapons workbench and storage and smith station. That's quite interesting. Now, okay, so we have made those drying racks, and I was wondering if they do require some time to dry that meat. So I'm gonna place that one over here. I think it does require, because it doesn't seem to be dried. No, so it does require few seconds or hours to dry our meat, because this doesn't look as dry. So that honestly does suck that we... How the hell am I supposed to do it? In the workbench of those guys? Oh shit, I need to make the smith again. Ah, that was so bad of me. Maybe I can make those Those benches. Oh, hello. I didn't need you. Yes, I can. Fantastic. So we're gonna be crafting that one in here. And the bat. Let's check if we can make bat over here. We can make baseball bat with glue and wood. And then we will require some barbed wire and baseball bat that we can make. Right, glue. We should have plenty. Oh, I need to get rid of those stairs over here. We should have plenty glue. That is right. Oh, guy outside. I mean, our guard is shooting. That is fantastic. And we need barbed wire. Let's check. What do we need to make barbed wire? Barbed wire, can we make it on us? Yes, we can. So that will take some time. And in so-called meantime, we can go and visit our lady that is doing the farming. Right, are you gonna shoot that bitch yelling at us? I guess not. So yeah, one of the guys asked me if the radius of this insect repellent light was 8 in the distance from here counting, but I think it is radius, total radius, or diameter of 8. So starting from there to there, that should be 8, at least what I can see from here. At the, I think that's the amount of blocks that this insect repellent light does cover. I'm not quite sure on that, but I will be testing. I will make this platform over there to test out the radius of this light, but we will do that later on. Right, we can make this electric bat, and that only takes 7 seconds, so that is not a long time. So we can do that and then test it out. Maybe we will even have a horde from the screamer. Of course, I will put this over here, mid drying rack. I can put it over here. We're not going to be dealing with that just yet, but for now those two weapons are really what I do design. Though having the small boy, I don't know if there's any purpose of this guard, of this survival, so yeah, I'm just getting rid of them since they do eat some food and I don't want to run out of it. And I do want 2 males, one for the smith that I have just killed and the second one for another guard. So that was really stupid of me to kill that guard. Okay, so let me just wait like a minute or so and then get back to you. Alrighty, so I have crafted those two weapons. This is electric bat, and the sound of it is really, really super duper awesome. Now let's check how much damage does it do. Well, entity damage 17. That is not a lot compared to the nail bat. That is like 50 levels lower, which does 27. I think that is much. Not so cool, but there's a electrical shock effect, 100%. And what is needed to repair is wood, which is really awesome. Really awesome. This one also requires wood, so we can repair that to the full stage. And in the full 361, it does 30 entity damage. Now, electric spear. The same goes with that one, I believe. Because, well, actually, this is quite similar level, so let me just get some forged iron and repair that thingy. Repair that. So, level 413 does 24 damage, and electrical spear does 22. A bit higher level, but still. And it also does the electrical shock effect as well. Okay, and the responsible, I don't know why, for electrical spear is the blunt weapons, but okay, fair enough. And for the bat is blunt weapons, of course. No, let's go and let's find some enemies, shall we? Let's hope that we won't die. There's another guy over here. I can hear that stupid screamer somewhere, so I assume she's over here? No. What the hell is she? She must be stuck somewhere. Oh, there she is. Oh, well, okay. Beating on the pillars over there. So let's not focus on her just yet. Boom, you are my Frankenstein bitch. Right, so I assume that the electrical shock effect does knock them down, especially when you hit them in the head. Fantastic stuff. Really cool. And now let's go with the... Ooh, shit, dude. That is something else. Now... Oh, look at that. There's the electrical shock. So it slows them down really... really rapidly. Right, let me just find a few other zombies to test my theory. So the electrical weapons would be awesome if you want to go out during the night time, I think. Now, of course, when I want to find any zombies whatsoever, there's none in the nearest vicinity. I can hear somebody, but probably he's in this house. And we don't want to fight indoors. Right, there are still some cars over here to be... Oh, shit! Okay, so let's test it on this bad boy. If it's gonna work on animals. Well, look at that, how slow that bitch is now. Fantastic. Oh, shit. Oh, I thought he's gonna... like jump on me or something. But that electrical shock is really useful, if you ask me. I think that the electrical shock wave might be passed from one zombie to another, but I am not so sure on making that statement. Mainly because I have absolutely no idea if that is a true or not. But as far as I remember, when I was taking... Oh, that was bright light. When I was taking apart cars, I have found few guys over here. And that we can attract and go over there and test my theory on them. Right, we're gonna go with electrical bat. Nope, it does not go from one zombie to another. But it works like a charm. We actually need quite a lot of hits. Boom, off you go. Now, electrical spear. Let's test. Whoops, whoops, whoops. Oh, shit. Ah, it only works on one of them. I was hoping that maybe you can pass the electrical charge to another guy. It does, it does slow them down, and maybe even it can hurt them. Furthermore, right in the balls. Nothing special, thank you. There's loads of what do you call them, holes in the cemetery since I've been digging over here. Oh, come on. So killing wise, even 440 quality bat is not so grand, but it sure does lower the speed of zombies drastically, as you saw. As you saw, guys. Okay, so I think on that note, we have fulfilled the mission of creating those electrical tools. And now, in so-called meantime, I shall be gathering... Where's my bike? Where is my bike? Have I left it over there? Where's my bike, goddammit? Or I did not took my bike, maybe? Okay, quite interesting. I think I haven't. Derp. Okay, guys, so that's gonna be it for today's episode. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, remember to leave a like, comment about the gameplay, subscribe to the channel if you're new and you like what you see, and I hope that we shall see each other in the next episode. So till then, take it easy. Have fun. Have gaming. And me, back to ranching. See you later.